This is the M18. Or what Banggood calls the EM4. This one comes with a couple of spare O-rings for the piston, rope starter, starting adapter for your cordless drill. You just want to carefully pull this foam up. This is essentially a water-cooled version of the EM2. It's not exactly the same. All of this is brass. Most of this is brass. It appears the crankcase is cast aluminum, then anodized. And this one is water-cooled. It has a pump. It's a gear pump. It'll take water from this cooling tank, pump it into the bottom of this cooling sleeve. When the water comes out the top, goes into the tank. Some screen wire in there to disperse the water, keep it from splashing, help with the cooling. Single needle valve control. The exhaust valve is operated by a cam that's behind this gear. And as usual, this is a 2-to-1 reduction off the crankshaft. This does not have a governor. There's no throttle, so this would appear to be speed limited strictly by the adjustment on the carburetor, and to some extent because it's running a load, which is this pump. Takes 3 batteries. Carburetor has a screen over it. I'm not really sure the intent of that screen. I suspect it's placed on there as a flame arrestor. These are always very close to the fuel tank. If this backfires, that will stop any combustion of fumes out here. There's a magnet in this gear. It passes over the Hall effect sensor, and that triggers the ignition. And I take a Sharpie and I mark the needle valve, and this is the position as received from the factory. I oil anything that wiggles, pivots, or turns. I put it on the springs, the valves, this rocker, the pivot point, this yoke down here where it runs into this follower for the cam. Put some oil on the gears, on the shaft where it exits, the crankcase on both sides. Put a little bit down here on this water pump. And as usual, I will use Coleman Lantern fuel with just a hint of Marvel Mystery Oil, just enough to turn it pink. I remove this breather cap, and I look down in there with a flashlight until I can see the bottom end of the connecting rod. Adjust some oil on that. I turn it upside down, and I drip some oil in there, so hopefully it'll get up there where the wrist pin is. And then in the crankcase, I put about that much oil, a few cc's, and hopefully that will splash around a little bit. The piston O-ring tends to have a little bypass, and so some of that Marvel Mystery Oil will accumulate down here in the crankcase as well. I encourage everyone to use distilled water in these engines, and then you won't have any accumulation of sediment in here from any hardness that's in the water. every drop of the oil that I put in here leaked out, and I think it's coming out between this crankcase and these brass end caps. There's probably no gasket in there. Every drop of it leaked out of there and made quite a mess. That's another reason why I use this plastic tarp. These can be a little messy. So every couple of runs, I'll take this off and just drip some oil on the upper and lower end of the connecting rod. And then I put a little oil on each side of where the crankshaft exits the crankcase. Sometimes you'll have one of these and they'll just quit and you don't know why. Well, you have to look around and see if you can find the problem. Yesterday, I didn't notice it, and that's one of the problems when you're trying to do one thing and run a camera at the same time. This spark plug wire got over here and is running on this flywheel, and it's starting to rub a little notch in that insulation. And this insulation is not that good. If you're grounded and you touch this when the engine is running, that spark will probably shock you. So you need to keep that away from the metal pieces. If it quits, you know, see if your fuel tank has gone dry, if the needle valve has changed its position, if one of the batteries has lost contact in the battery pack, see if you have compression. This engine has pretty good compression. And this is running better than it did the first couple of times. Part of that is learning how to adjust this carburetor. This is very sensitive. The instructions say to open the needle valve 1/4 turn. If you open this 1/4 turn, you will not get a single fire out of it. It will not run. So this needle valve, this carburetor in my engine is about 1/8 of a turn open. It's where it starts. Then after it warms up, play with that a little bit. Engine is hot, the water tank is hot. I go ahead and I shut it off before I run out of fuel. There is no reason to run one of these until it gets so hot that it quits. This is a model engine. It's not meant for that. Use a little discretion when you're running one of these and it will last you a long time.